we can be upheld in you. Amen.
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 Let me, this morning I was telling you, or this afternoon, about the experience I had with God in the sacrament of reconciliation. I mean, this is the reason why it has become, it had such a great effect on me, and it has become, maybe if you can call it like this, maybe my favorite sacrament.
A little higher.
As I shared with you, when I came home from this experience, I was still doing my is as in part of a ministry to hear confessions on Saturdays. And I had sometimes 4 to 6 people who came for confession. I was wondering whether the way that sacrament was celebrated, whether it was really an encounter. But I was thinking about all the thousands and thousands of people who do not come on a Saturday, or even who the attendance was very, the experience was very low, the attendance. And so when I came home, that was the moment also that there was from the Vatican a mission to celebrate the sacrament of reconciliation with general absolution. And I said, oh, that's it. This is something, you know, we should look forward. Everybody can be, you know, more people can experience God's forgiveness in that way. So that's why we started, you know, listening about where this was going to happen. Okay? And I heard that in Baclaran Church there would be a celebration, a penitential celebration, and, you know, a general absolution. I went there, and the church was filled up with people. And it was a nice celebration. I really believe that my sins were forgiven. But definitely, for me, something was lacking. The personal experience was not there. And so together with the team, we started reflecting about the sacrament and how we could make this available to more people and to let more people experience in a personal way the sacrament of forgiveness. And what helped us very much was the Tagalog term for confession on pabalik loob. Ibig sabihin, ibabalik ko ang aking loob. Hindi ibibigay ko ang aking loob, ibabalik ko ang aking loob. I only return something that does not belong to me. Otherwise, I give it. But then the question is, to whom I return this law, this inner power of mine? And Blaise Pascal, you know, somebody came up with the idea that Blaise Pascal said that in the law of every person, there is a vacuum that can only be filled with God. But true. I had in my ministry the chance to be with very rich people. They have everything. And still when you are with them, they are still looking for something, searching for something. Because they do feel there is an emptiness there. Although they seem to have everything, they did not realize that it is an emptiness that can only be filled by God. Not with any material possession, not with any other person. If I say that I have to return the law, then I can realize also that I have been watching sometimes on the TV, and you look at the television, black and white, still blue. When you come out of them, of the shanty, and you ask yourself, what do we have? What is there that they have? Something would say, well, come on, why don't you enter into society with people? But there is somewhere in the inner peace. Maybe it's true that in the lobe of every person, there is a vacuum that can only be filled with God. I had the chance to be in Rome to attend a retreat of priests, and Mother Teresa was the guest speaker. We were asked not to stand up so that if she would come in, we would notice her because she's small. And then she walks through this little corridor and gets on the podium and starts talking. She doesn't say anything new, nothing that I have not heard before. But how come 6,000 people were just there listening, caught by her words, caught by her presence? Is it maybe that she has given so much space to God in her loop that wherever she comes, people experience that someone else is there also? John Paul came to the Philippines the first time, and Lonnie de Castro was the anchorman television. One was there, or the Rojas Boulevard. I was so enthusiastic, I can see the bombard coming, the Pope is very near, and all of a sudden, his voice cracks. He waits for a while, he recovers. Later on, they ask him, Lonnie, what happened to you? You are such a seasoned speaker. And you know, we have been doing this for so many years. He said, I do not know. When my eyes came across his eyes, I felt like someone else was there also. So Paul, even when he on his last worldly day in Canada, when he could hardly speak, and millions were there, everybody was saying, we don't understand what he is saying, but we feel his presence. These are maybe people who have given so much space to God that whenever they come in the presence of people, they feel like someone else is there. If sacrament of reconciliation can be said that it is a returning of the space that belongs to God, maybe we can find also a description of what sin would be. That sin maybe is reducing God's space in my life. And if I don't give back the space that belongs to Him, there comes a time I don't hear Him anymore, I cannot experience Him anymore, I have no time for Him anymore. I have experienced this. I could talk and preach still about God, but He was not a part of my life. I had reduced Him almost to no more space for you. I run my life. I became in one way my own God. The good thing with God is that no matter how we reduce His space in our world, we can never get Him out. I have carved your name in the palm of my hand. And even if your mother will forget you, it is almost impossible, I will not forget you. I am just waiting to give you back the space that belongs to me, so that I can make a home in you, and you can feel at home with me. This is what we will celebrate tonight. You know, as we did that, as we developed this concept of, you know, celebrating it with many people God's mercy and making it more a personal encounter, we started developing a ceremony where we give a lot of time preparing people, okay, for this sacrament. And then asking them to come forward, okay, lining up for the communion meal here. And then one by one, we would lay hands on them and give them the assurance of God's forgiveness. And then welcome them home. We developed these celebrations, and on Holy Week, we had 6 celebrations, and we had almost 2,300 people who would come to the celebration. What was touching for me as a priest, as a pastor, was to see man standing in front of you who would never get into the confessional box, but would experience in that way God's your forgiveness, encountering personally God. When I transferred them to Benny Hill in 1990, we had a lot of students who would come to look for our retreats. And we would have people from the graduates of LaSalle University would come. And they would ask me, okay, can you also help us in celebrating the sacrament, you know, of reconciliation, maybe in a different way, you know, maybe a more personal way, a more experiential way. I had the chance at that time to talk, to read the book of Henry Nouwen, The Coming Home. And this is where I developed gradually with the team the idea of looking at the sacrament, of the sacrament of coming home. Kasi coming home talaga is very Filipino. If you look at the airport, there's no airport in the whole world that can be compared with the airport in the Philippines. Because someone is coming home. The jeepneys are lined up for someone coming home. And if you are waiting for your luggage, then you can see the body buying boxes coming out with all the gifts. And all the gifts are for the body of Barangay Captain, to the Milan Marina, to the relatives, and so on. Because somebody is coming home. So, when we started reading that and reflecting about the book of Henry Nouwen, on the parable, there are 2 things that struck us very much, and which will be very meaningful as we will celebrate the sacrament. First one is, the son is sitting there among the pigs. And one day he decides to come home. We all know that the father has been waiting there for a long time to look at the direction, for hoping that the son would come home. But nothing happened. Nothing could happen because he did not decide to come home. But that day he decided to come home. And the Tagalog version is very nice, tumindiksya, and he stood up. It was a turning point. All the rest belongs to the father. And the only thing that he had to do is, I want to go home. I want to go home. When we were celebrating this sacrament of coming home for priests, one day, you know, after the celebration, the priest came to me and he said, Father Mark, I'm sorry, I did not join because I cannot. I decided to stay still among the pigs. It was such a painful and such an honest confession of him, saying, I cannot go home yet. I'm not ready yet. Although I was saying, you know, it would be what happened, a wonderful experience for you to come home. Because there are no questions and there are no promises to be made. Because if we read the story, the man decided to come home. You know, and I'm sure that, you know, having destroyed so many things, the family lived that kind of life, that I do believe that he was aware that his father would be angry. Who would not be angry? And so he prepared a little speech. Father, will consider many warriors, son just one of your slaves. And as the story goes, we all know it is not the son who runs to the father, it is the father who runs to the son. And in my imagination, his story, the way it is told by Henry. You know, the father embraces him in such a way that he can hardly say any word. Only after a few minutes he can say, "Father, do not consider me anymore your son, just one of your slaves." What's the answer? Put sandals on his feet, put a cloak on him, put a ring on his finger, because he is my son. No matter what happened, I am so happy he came home. The father did not say, "Son, Tekomuna, before you get near, can you answer all the questions that I will ask you? Is it true what that you have done this or that?" No questions. "I'm so happy you came home." That was the only thing that he heard. The father did not say, "Son, Tekomuna, before you come nearer, do you promise you will never do it again?" No questions, no promises, just a big hug. "I'm so happy you came home." This is what I believe sacrament is all about. An experience that we are forgiven. An experience that God at this very moment is forgiving me, whatever went wrong, whatever I have done. Tonight, I will be just God's instrument. I'm not better than any one of you. I don't think that. It's simply that God needs someone so that we can hear, so that we can experience his forgiveness. And that's the reason why I will ask you a favor. I will kneel down and I will ask you, some of you, to come near and lay hands on me and pray that I may be a good instrument so that you may experience God's forgiveness. So I just kneel down. We would like now to prepare ourselves for this encounter. So that it becomes a meaningful encounter and not just a ritual. Because only encounters change a person, not so much rituals. And we will be guided by this settings of chairs, which will affect the relationships. We will ask you to participate in it. And we ask you that you be, if ever you feel like cracking a joke or whatever it is, to keep it maybe for after the celebration. So that it becomes a meaningful experience of reflecting on relationships, using this situation's lessons.
Para po sa paghahanda natin for the sacrament of coming home, we would like to use a version of Panginoon Maawa Ka. Panginoon Maawa Ka sa
Pag-init po natin, Panginoon ang Panginoon.
Panginoon, awa ka sa amin. Panginoon, awa ka.
let's move on to this next slide. Let us reflect on what kind of situation people are in this image, and what could be the words that are coming out of their mouths. Ano po kaya yung mga salita na lumalabas sa kanilang mga bibig? Let's offer po a few moments of silence. And again, anyone who is ready may say aloud the dialogue that is happening here in this situation. Panginoon, maawa ka.
Panginoon, maawa ka sa amin. Panginoon, maawa ka sa amin.
And anyone who is ready may again put a dialogue in this image, in this situation.
Sino ba ang parish dito? nag-uusap lang po. Bumaba ka naman sa pedestal mo. Hindi ka na namin maabot.
Obey me.
Hindi tayo magkatuda.
Nakakangalay na pong tumingala parati.
Lonely here on top.
Have pity on me.
Ang pinakikinig sa sasabihin mo.
Sorry, hindi kita kalete.
So?
Sino bang mas na maraming pinag-aralan sa akin?
Panginoon, maawa ka.
Panginoon, maawa ka sa amin. Panginoon, maawa ka sa amin.
And one is filled, they put their diet.
Pagod na ako.
Bakit dati yung kinahabang?
I can still understand.
Hindi mo alam kung gano'ng kapigat ang dalawa kayo.
I'm about to give up with such a relationship.
Mabigat kang dalhin.
Gagawin ko ang lahat. Maabot ko lang yung goal ko.
Okay, makakaroon. Kaya na yung control.
Masaya ka ba sa mga dalawa?
Tayo-tayo lang nakasama.